I'm Stephen, welcome to Teachy Films. For like a year now, the Nintendo Switch's eShop is like a cluster at the moment, because we're seeing some what mobile ports cashing in and some various different games. There's just quite a number of games, I should say, that is some bad ones as well. Now let's delve into a few, shall we? So here are my top 5 bad Nintendo Switch games. Let's get to it. I love the disclaimers. It's so bad.
Who's bad?
Now, there are some games that actually got that are not that kind of bad, to be honest, but there are some games out there, even though there's a ton of the game in the eShop, but they do kind of discount certain games, despite tone. Sure, they might be somewhat bad, but hey, that's how you cash in somewhat games and is whatever games that they do put on the eShop. Now, rather pick some games I actually have that are bad in terms of like performance, gameplay, etc., etc., than is, you know, when it comes to certain ports coming to the Nintendo Switch, I should say. Speaking about ports while I quit with Jibber Jabber, let's give them number 5, and that is WWE 2K18. Now, I don't usually buy the good old sports games for that matter, but this is, however, a bit of an exception, despite, impacted the whole WWE games when it comes to Nintendo, than it is ports for the Nintendo Switch for that matter, because it is quite limited for you, the Nintendo Switch, to be able to port games like this, big AAA-ish games like this, to a handheld, and it is kind of a struggle for most developers, and this, however, really struggled in somewhat way in terms of performance and this and that, but it's okay-ish, but it's still bad nonetheless, because this really impacted the WWE games for that matter for the Nintendo Switch, and since then they've not been doing much WWE games despite the NBA ones. So they're currently releasing NBA 2K20 for that matter this year, but sadly they just haven't been doing it for like 2 odd years, so we're not going to be seeing another WWE game on Nintendo Switch anytime soon, which kind of sucks really. But if you want to play a real fighting game on the Nintendo Switch, get, you know, Smash Bros. Enough said and done. But do keep in mind, I mainly got this game, despite I'm aware that it's a bad port, but because me and my friend were playing WWE on a different platform, I thought, hey, this is quite neat, we'll play this on the go. But we did somewhat enjoy it, despite, playing games like this on the Nintendo Switch for that matter. But hey, it was a good giggle when I got it, I should say. But I'm going to keep it either way, just for the fact that you know that you're not going to get another WWE game anytime soon for that matter. Haha. So that's number 5, and at number 4 is Kitten Squad. Now, when I did a video about free-to-play games for the Nintendo Switch, I know that I got somewhat people saying, hey, why did you choose this one? This looks quite bad. Yes, I'm aware that it's quite bad now, but at the time though, when it comes to free-to-play games, there were literally like 5-odd games you can play on the Nintendo Switch free-to-play wise. But hey, I was making the video at the time, and like I said, there were like 5-odd free-to-play games, but yes, this was quite bad, I should say, when it comes to this sort of game. Anywho, but yes, it is quite bad, and the performance is somewhat alright, but the game, however, despite the awkward sound effects, it is quite bad, honestly, a free-to-play game. But hey, it's free-to-play, and despite the only thing you have to pay for, knowing cosmetics when it comes to free-to-play games, and as you know, spend £5 for the full lot of characters, and that's it. But all the base game is free-to-play, for that matter. Despite, I was unsure to get like, like a Blind of Isaac or Enter the Gungeon kind of thing, but I end up getting like Crypto the Necrodancer when it comes to dungeon crawling and randomly generated kind of ish games, but this, however, is kind of not recommended in somewhat way unless you're that eager to play somewhat free games on the Nintendo Switch. It not saying, well, it is quite bad. It's okay enough, if you, but I still recommend, like, at least, like, Crypt of the NecroDancer, when that's on sale when it comes to, you know, dungeon crawling kind of games. Then it is if it weren't for a certain Octavius Kitten mention about the game after giving her some eShop credit for Christmas and whatnot. So she can get Crypt of the NecroDancer and would not mention about it on stream, and I would not have got it myself. I still recommend Crypt of the NecroDancer when it comes to that sort of game better than this blooming catastrophic kind of game. So that's number four, and at number three is Hollow. I've seen this game like numerous of times, like under £1 when it's on sale, and despite him, I like my first person shooters as I do, but I had like a spare pound and I thought, why not, I'll just buy this and see what it's like. And I kind of regretted it because it's not kind of good, because the first person aspects is a bit clunky despite using whatever weapons and this and that. I just kind of not get grasp of it, alone horror games are a different topic, because horror and despite him scary and kind of games are not my forte, I should say. But I mainly got this because it was under £1. I thought I'd see what it's like. The graphics though are quite good, but the performance though sadly are really really clunky, and I just can never get to grips with this game. So yeah, I do recommend this when it's for under £1, when it's on sale, but don't buy it full price because it's like £15, even though there is the PC version of this. I'm not so sure how the PC performs on this alone, you know, pointing this on the Nintendo Switch. Again, like I said, it does look good, but performance in general is a bit eh. But it does have them, I should say, boobs. It has boobs in this game. So at least you get somewhat enjoyment despite getting your butt whooped by boobs in the game, because they're like these half naked kind of things you have to take out because it's meant to be like a Dead Space kind of scary kind of game, I should say. But hey, it's kind of worth it for under £1 just for the boobs alone. So that's number three, and at number two is Home Escape. Talk about that 24-hour countdown timer from the TV show 24, but get used to that 10-second loop. Oh, it's so annoying, even though when you find that little gap where you know it repeats. But yeah, I kind of got this game a few weeks ago on the same day it came out when it was at launch, when I was browsing for the eShop. I was like, ooh, this is quite neat, just by somewhat watching the trailer, despite utilising the Joy-Cons. Then when I tried the game out for myself, okay then. But I didn't realise on the actual level you can actually calibrate your Joy-Cons on the fly, that is trying to do whatever in the game, even though, you know, doing this and that in the level, because, you know, as you can see, I'm trying to swat cats while trying to, you know, save this poor innocent child. Even if the game kind of tells you what to do, then it is, you know, making sure you're within time, within the beat. It's somewhat of a ribbon game. Then it is, you know, making sure you're using the right Joy-Cons to pull and whatnot. I kind of did a different method to be able to play somewhat this game. But yeah, swing your arms about like you're playing Wii Boxing does kind of work, but the Joy-Cons in this game are a bit eh, but it's quite bad, I should say, despite, you know, this game came out just literally a few weeks ago. So that's number two, and at number one is... Yes, Dead Fun Pack Penguins and Aliens Strikes Again. Wow, that's a bit of a mouthful. Then it is, this game used to be like £7 odd, and I got this on sale for like, I guess under £1-ish. But anywho, yeah, I can see why this was on sale now and again for like around £1 or under £1 or whatever. I kind of regretted getting this, despite the screenshots alone, because when I was looking at the screenshots, I thought, hey, this is quite good. It's got like, you know, that Game Boy or Game & Watch kind of feel, but oh, this would be quite cool. And, you know, I thought it'd be like one of those cool, nifty, endless runner games. And boy, I was wrong. Then it is, until when you first start the game and you constantly die, it gets kind of repetitive with this sound. Rest in peace, headphone users, but that introduction alone for a video game is really off-putting, and it just really puts me off the game entirely just by the first section of the game. Even though with the changing camera angles when you're just trying to jump and the jump accuracies are a bit off, sure, they'll give you like an instability for a little bit, but it's still not even enough. And the annoying sound, and then it is rinse and repeating and miss do your jumps, and I thought Dark Souls was hard enough.
Eventually.
I did, however, get to the second level, but it's just still bad enough just from the awkward and jumping mechanics. There's the changing camera angles on the fly, and it just makes it more stressful after between levels. Then it is, this is a two games in one, and this game does have like a second game, which is like a whack-a-mole kind of alien whack-a-mole kind of game. But that alone is a little alright. It's quite fun, but it does get a bit harder, and it's still somewhat stressful on this monstrosity when it comes to this blooming game, despite constantly dying. You die, you die, you die. So those were my top 5 bad Nintendo Switch games. Hope you'll enjoy it. Yes, there were a cluster of, you know, games on the Nintendo Switch. You had to put up with the good, with the bad, despite, you know, that's life in general. But there were quite a number of games, I should say, on the eShop at the moment, because, you know, no mobile developers, you know, porting in their games when it comes to stuff you can get on mobile devices, because, you know, the Nintendo Switch is a mobile device, you know, little developers cashing in whatever games that they can develop, even with the bad ones. But I know for a fact that there are some really better cheap games out there that I played myself, and which I do kind of recommend than these particular games. But you know, we're coming up to the point now where there's a low of particular games on the Nintendo Switch, both the good and the bad, I should say. But avoid all the bad ones, by all means. If you do see a game that's like under £1, it's not good to be true, I should say, when it comes to whatever games, but I'm a sucker when it comes to buying whatever cheap games from a Nintendo Switch, both good and bad. Anyways, I'm going to go now before I go into a tangent about it. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.